Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's learn the lesson Landscape of the Soul by Natalie Troveroy from class 11 Hornbill. If you're listening to my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to all the lessons pertaining to class 10, 11 and 12 English. Please press the notification button so that you get notified whenever I post a video. About the author. Natalie Troveroy is an art historian who came in limelight because her translated work, City of Jinns, a book by William Dalrymple. She has traveled various cities of the world with her husband. She holds a master's degree in history of art and archaeology from the University of Belgium. She plans to write her next book on old Delhi architecture like Jama Masjid and Chandni Chowk. Introduction. Chapter Landscape of the Soul by Natalie Troveroy is about art. The chapter consists of two parts. The first part has been taken from Landscape of the Soul, Ethnics and Spirituality in Chinese Painting, and the second part is from Getting Inside Outsider Art, an article written by Brinda Suri in Hindustan Times. Let's look at the summary of the story. The first section is about the art of painting. There are two stories in it. The first story is about Wu Daozi, a famous Chinese painter who lived in the 18th century. He was a master painter and was commissioned by the Tang Emperor Xuanzong to decorate the palace wall. He made a beautiful painting with high mountains, forests, waterfalls, clouds floating in clear big blue sky, men walking and working on hilly paths, birds in flight, and a cave situated at the foot of the mountain where lived a spirit. As the painter was showing the painting to the emperor, he clapped hands. Immediately the entrance to the cave opened, the painter got in, the painting vanished, and Wu Daozi never came out. The disappearance of the painting from the wall signifies the knowledge of the spiritual inner world. Only the masters know the way within and can go beyond any material appearance. In the next story, a famous Chinese painter refused to draw the eye of a dragon he had painted, for he feared that it would fly away out of the painting. The third story is about Antwerp. A master blacksmith called Quinten Metzes fell in love with a painter's daughter. The father would not accept a son-in-law in such a profession. However, Antwerp had to accept Quinten Metzes as his son-in-law because he painted a fly on his panel with such delicate realism that it looked like a real one. The author also talks about Chinese philosophy Shan Shui, which means mountain water. The mountain represents yang, the male principle, and water signifies yin, the female principle. In the next section, the author talks about the concept of art brut, which means the art of those who have no right to be artists as they have not received any formal training, yet show talent and artistic insight. There's artists who think out of the box. Their works are totally different from those of their predecessors. In simple words, this art can be called unorthodox art. In this section, the author talks about Nek Chand's creations. His creation of rock garden at Chandigarh is an expression of art brut. Question and answers. Question number 1. What wonderful tale is told about the Chinese painter Wu Daozi? Answer. The Chinese emperor commissioned the painter Wu Daozi to decorate the palace walls with landscape paintings. He did his job very well, but worked behind a curtain. Only the king could see and admire it. But the painter got into a cave, no less beautiful. The gate closed before the king could enter it. All the paintings also disappeared along with the creator. Question number 2. What did the Chinese philosophers try to achieve through their storybooks? Answer. The two Chinese philosophers included many stories in their books. They meant to guide their disciples in the right direction. Second, the stories reveal the spirit in which art was considered in ancient China. Question number 3. Bring out in brief the contrast between European art and Chinese art. Answer. The European or Western landscape reproduces the actual view. It creates the illusion of reality. The painter wants the viewers to see his work through his eyes and from a specific angle. The Chinese landscape is vague. It calls upon the viewers to use their eyes as well as imagination to see its inner beauty. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments. Thank you for watching.